Good morning. Yep, ya. Yeah. Good morning Ibu Maida Nurahmi as the reviewer and Nining Oktoriani Sari as the student who is being examined this morning, not really examined, ya. Yeah. Her work is being reviewed. Yeah, will be reviewed this morning and all the students who are present here now. So we are going to have a thesis proposal seminar for Miming Oktoriani Sari, yeah. But before we start the seminar, would you like to pray first, Mimi? Do you need time to pray? Yeah, you are muted. Kamu masih di mute, jadi Ibu nggak dengar.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh ya, oke, silahkan ya. Okay, finish.
Finish, ma'am.
Okay. So, on the behalf of English Education Study Program, so I officially announce that this thesis proposal seminar is open. Yeah. And as usual, this seminar consists of three sessions, three parts. The first one is presentations. So you present the main point of your proposal. Yeah, you don't read everything. Yeah, you can share screen to share your PowerPoint. And then after that, your proposal will be reviewed by Ibu Maida, and then the last part, you will have the result. Yeah, after being reviewed. Yeah, your work being reviewed by Ibu Maida. Okay, you can start by having the presentations. Yeah, time is yours, Mimin. Yeah.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Can anyone see my PowerPoint?
Not yet. Oh ya, sudah.
Okay.
Sudah muncul. Ini Dianu aja ya, Ming. Apa namanya?
Apa, Ming?
Di slide show aja ya. Tapi ya lebih mudah sih, enaknya enak buat di slide show aja.
Oh, bentar, Ming. Kelihatan, Ming? Sudah, Ming? Okay. Thank you for the time. My name is Miming Oktoriani Sari. Today I would like to present my thesis proposal. The title of my thesis proposal, The Effect of Collaborative Strategic Reading and Whisperies to Students' Reading Comprehension of Narrative Text. I would like to say thank you for my advisors, Ma'am Yuli Triana and also Ma'am Susani Ronopa and also the reviewer today, Ma'am Maida Nurahmi. My thesis proposal consists of three chapters, so I will go to the first chapter, introduction. The first, research background. People and the first research background, the people interact using English as the most widely recognized international language of communication, especially for the students. Students in school are expected to be able to be master for skill of English, the first listening, the second speaking, the third reading, and the last is writing. One of the very important skill to be master is reading because it considered as the most frequently used in school for the students. Many aspects can make students' reading habits is still poor. For the example, from the family environment, reading infrastructure, students' motivation, difficult find good media and lack strategy for learning reading. According to the researcher interview with the English teacher and students in SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya, English teacher has difficulty to choose good strategy and good media for teaching reading, especially narrative text and also about the students. Based on the explanation above, the researcher is interested to conduct research entitled The Effect of Collaborative Strategic Reading and Whisperies to Students' Reading Comprehension of Narrative Text. The research problem, based on the research background, the problem of the research is do collaborative strategic reading and whisperies give significant effect to the senior high school students' reading comprehensions of narrative text? And the research delimitation, The researcher will delimit this research on the effect of collaborative strategic reading and whisperies to improve student senior high school students' reading comprehensions of narrative text at 11 grade of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya, and the focus of reading material of this research is narrative text and the theories about reading comprehension level. And the research objective, the research objective is to prove whether collaborative strategic reading and whisperies give me significant effect on students' reading comprehension of narrative text. And the research significant is R for the students, English teacher, and the next researcher. And the last definition of key terms, the first, is collaborative strategic reading. Collaborative strategic reading is a strategy of teaching reading comprehension by applying several strategies. The first is preview, the second click and clang, the third get the gist, and the last wrap up in combination with working cooperatively. The second, whisperies, an application for teaching media that contains hundreds of original and new children animation books that allow the reader to read tales wherever they want. The third, reading comprehension. Reading comprehension is the ability to understand a text, analyze the content of the text, and accurately interpret what the writer states. In this research, the reading comprehension refers to the reading comprehension of narrative text. And the last, narrative text. Narrative text is a text contains of story, fiction or non-fiction, fairy tales, fables, or myth, and has a plot that consists of orientation, complication, and resolution. The specific one that used in this research are fables and fairy tales. The next chapter, literature review. In literature review, there are concept and theory, and concept and theory consists of four points. The first point, reading. The second, collaborative strategic reading. The third point, teaching and learning media whisperies. And the last, narrative text. And the second, preview study. The preview study for the first preview study, the effect of collaborative strategic reading strategy on students' reading comprehension at Islamic Senior High School Al Karim in 2021 by Wulan Rahmapani. The purpose of this research is to find out whether there is a significant effect of collaborative strategic reading strategy in descriptive text of the 10 grad students at Islamic Senior High School Al Karim. The second, the effectiveness of collaborative strategic reading on the students' reading comprehension achievement at the 8th grade students of SMP Negeri 1 Janangan Ponorogo in 2017 by Dina Permatasari. The objective of this research is to find out whether there is significant difference between the students' reading comprehension achievement who are taught by using CSR and who are not taught by using CSR at the 8th grade students of SMP Negeri 1 Janangan Ponorogo. And the last, the influence of collaborative strategic reading technique on the students' reading skill in drawing conclusion at the 11th grade of SMK Ganesha Sekampung in 2019 by Leonardi Purnawan. The purpose of this research are to show that using collaborative strategic reading materials can be effective for the students' reading skill in drawing conclusion. And the last chapter is research method. The first, design of the research. The researcher used pre-experimental design with the form of one group pretest and post-test design. And for the population and sample, the population of this research is at 11 grade students at SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. And the sample, the researcher used cluster random sampling. It means the researcher choose a group that exists in the population at random. And the assumption, of this research, the first, the 11 grad students of SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya have studied English of narrative text. And the second, the use of collaborative strategic reading and whisperies in narrative text could give an effect on students' reading comprehension. And the hypothesis, for the null hypothesis, there is no significant effect of using collaborative strategic reading and whisperies to students' reading comprehension of narrative text at SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. and the alternative hypothesis, there is a significant effect of using collaborative strategic reading and whisperies to students' reading comprehension of narrative text at SMA Negeri 3 Palangkaraya. And the definition of operational variable, there are two variables in this research. For the first, independent variable. The independent variable of this research refer to the using collaborative strategic reading and whisperies. And the dependent variable is refers to the student achievement in reading comprehension of narrative text. And the next is technique of data collection. The data collection consists of 7 points. The first is fit test, and the next treatment, the next post test, the next checking, the next coding, the next scoring, and the last tabulating. And the technique of data analysis, the first, the researcher will test the normality of the data on the test using score using the Sapir-Whorf normality test. And the second, after the normality of the data on the student score, the researcher will use paired sample t-test if the data distributed normally to testing the hypothesis of the research. And if the data not distributed normally, the researcher will use Wilkerson non-parametric test. And the last, research instrument. For the research instrument, have 5 points. The first in instrument development, the second is instrument tryout, and the third is instrument validity, and the last instrument reliability. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Miming. Okay, now it's time for Ibu Maida to review your proposal. So, time is yours, Ibu Maida.
Thank you very much, Ibu Yuli. Good morning, everyone. Good morning, audience. And good morning, Miming. Congratulations for making or reaching this stage so far. So, this is your first step to get your Bachelor of Education later on. Actually, I put a lot of comments in the file. Most of them are mechanical and technical problems. So I think you just can read my comments on the file. I'll send the file back later to you through WhatsApp. But today, I just want to discuss about some important points with you. I think those points are quite essential to make your research better, or at least to make it organized and structured. First of all, have you learned about how to make quotation, Mimi?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, quotation seems not really essential, but yours are quite disturbing for me. So many mistakes in quoting the ideas from the resources. I just want to know whether you know about how to differentiate between direct quotation and indirect quotation. What is direct quotation for you? Direct or direct?
Direct quotation is that when we quote a quotation from someone's research, that we need we cannot restate the researcher.
Why don't we do the restatement? Why in some point we are able to make that indirect quotation, in some point we just need to make direct quotation?
I don't know, ma'am. I kind of a bit forget about it.
Okay, if you forget, it makes sense because a lot of mistakes in quoting the ideas. First of all, most of your quotation in your proposal seems to be direct quotation. Do you know what is the physical mark, tanda fisik for direct quotation?
The mark, Miss. Boleh saya jawab di bahasa Indonesia, Miss?
Okay,
go on. Tanda kutip, ma'am.
Yes, tanda kutip. And almost all of your quotation in tanda kutip. So I just want to know what is your reason to do something like that?
Because in my opinion that I...
Not in your opinion, based on the series, not your opinion. Okay.
Because I cannot restate their statement.
Why? Why you cannot restate it?
Because direct quotation, ma'am.
Because that's direct quotation. Maybe you need to learn again, maybe, how to differentiate. I put some comments on how to make it. I give you some comments in some point. I just said, make this indirect. Because for me, it's quite acceptable and it's very common when you use indirect one. Because the ideas will be long. If it is too long, you need to do the restatement. Get my point?
Yes.
Not all of the quotation, it's like you just take the ideas and put in your proposal. Take and put. Ambil taruh without any bridge. Because in my opinion, and the things that I know so far, when you want to make direct quotation, you need to make the bridge between the previous sentence and then the bridge and then the direct quotation. So make sure about it. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
It's quite disturbing for me.
Yes, ma'am. Mistake, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. That's quotation. Now let's go to the significance of the study. Significance of the study, page. Before going to significance of the study, I just want to discuss about research problem with you.
Yes.
Okay, can you read your research problem?
Do collaborative strategic reading and whisperies give significant effect to the senior high school students' reading comprehension of narrative text?
Okay, do you think this is the correct form of research problem in quantitative research?
No.
Why no? Why you put it here if it is no?
Usually I saw in quantitative research that is there any effect of
why not using that?
Because I think in the time, I think that is there is same with do.
No, just go back to the previous one. Is there any? Can you?
Yes, ma'am.
I put my comment on this kind of point. You are free to make variations, Mimi, in your proposal, but not the basic ones. Yeah.
Okay, ma'am.
Boleh variasi, but not the basic one. Okay, significant of the study. Which one? Okay, read the first significance for students.
The students can have new experience for their reading comprehension by learning using collaborative strategic reading and whisperies as their learning strategy and learning media.
Okay, I know what you want to say, but I just want to a little bit comment on this and give you feedback, because do you think it's enough just new experience? For example, when I am a student, I use CSR for example. And then I just get new experience. And my comprehension, my comprehension doesn't work well after using this. So do you think it's experience?
Sorry, ma'am.
Is it only experience when the student successfully use collaborative strategic reading? Is it only experience?
No, ma'am.
What is it? Or what are they?
I want that the students have significant effect.
Make it more realistic. Make it more realistic in common language or daily language.
I want them that can, when they are read a text, I want their comprehension is more improvement.
Okay, they can improve their comprehension. Why? In this kind of point, in significance for students, you just say that the students can have new experience. New experience doesn't mean they can improve their reading competence or their reading comprehension. You get my point, Miming?
Yes, ma'am.
You need to, what is that? You need to fix this kind of sentence.
Yes.
This sentence is too, what is that? Just a surface sentence. What I mean is that you have to make the significance more reliable and realistic. For example, contohnya, the student can use this strategy in this CSR whenever they read narrative text, and then they can get the clues, gifs, and information. And then they can practice to use CSR also in other texts, for example. Itu significance-nya, not just new experience. If you are talking about experience, it's very, very surface. Surface banget. Yes. Experience, for example, I'm using new headset for now. So I have the experience, right?
Yes.
Using a new headset. But it doesn't mean that I can use that kind of new headset for my comprehension. It can be, I don't like the size, I don't like blah, blah, blah. Yeah, do you get the point?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, the same for teacher and also researcher. Okay, did you read buku panduan atau buku pedoman?
Yes.
Sure.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, 100%?
70.
Make it 90.
Yes.
Definition of key terms in quantitative research, you will not find any. So there is no definition.
I cannot put the definition of key terms.
You just look back your buku panduan. If I'm not mistaken, I'm very sorry, but I think and I believe that there is no definition of key terms in buku panduan for quantitative.
This is
for qualitative.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, make sure, yeah.
Yeah.
I put my comments there. Okay, for literature review. Let's talk about the CSR.
Yes.
Your title is The Effect of CSR
and Whisperies.
At first, I think Whisperies is also strategy when reading a title.
Yes.
And I just know when I read your proposal that Whisperies is a kind of media.
Yes, ma'am.
So which one do you want to test or you want to experiment? CSR or the Whisperies?
Both of them.
Are you sure? Both of them?
Because I want that the Whisperies as their learning media.
Mm-hmm.
I want to that the material for learning teaching CSR I got from the Whisperies, ma'am.
So what do you do with the media?
I adapt from the Whisperies the materials for the students reading narrative text.
The students directly access the media or you?
The students, ma'am.
The students.
Uh-uh.
And then, is there any significant effect later when they use whispers for their reading comprehension just to access it? Because
in whispers, it also has animated.
Yes.
It can help.
Animated narrative.
Yes. It can help their comprehension, ma'am.
In your opinion, the students' reading comprehension will be achieved atau can be achieved by using whispers or CSR?
Using CSR.
So, my comments, this is very essential, Mimi, you can talk to your advisor. Do not put any whispers in the strategy. The strategy is CSR, not whispers. Whispers is only the media. You can talk about whispers in your proposal, but not as the strategy. Because the strategy has been already listed, right? You take this kind of strategy from Oxford, blah blah blah.
Yes.
Am I right? Oxford, blah blah blah. I forget about the full resources. Yeah, from Oxford. Yeah. So for me, it's better to experiment the strategy because in your RPP or lesson plan, it mainly talks about the strategy, not the whispers. The whispers, I read the whispers in your RPP. You take the materials from the whispers. Yes. Only taking the materials,
yes,
right? So for me, it's not really significant later if you put whispers as one of your variable.
Oh, okay.
For me, but you can talk to your advisors. I just want to make it easier.
Yes.
Okay. So it's about in CSR, you have click and clumps.
Yes.
Yeah. Tell me about it. What is click? What is clump?
Click when students understand that the word, and then clung when student doesn't understand the word, ma'am. In the text.
How can you put it in an example? Give me examples.
Like the example, I'm the students. I am not understand that like star means bintang in bahasa Indonesia. I am not understand that star, what is star is, but so I write that the star in a learning log.
Yeah, I know.
So that's the clang. So
if you don't understand the words, so the words are clangs.
Yes.
Okay, what about clicks?
Click if I understand like the moon, like something like that.
Bulan, okay.
I know that moon is bulan. Okay. So I write in the learning log, moon is bulan, and then for the clang, star.
Okay. So you make it empty for the star because you don't understand the meaning. Mm-hmm.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, very good. I just want to test you whether you know about it or not, because when you want to test or experiment a strategy, there are some terms and you need to know. It is very essential for you to know how it works.
Yes,
if you don't know, the result of your research will be questionable.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's go to final minute. We are going to previous study. There are three kinds of previous study talking about CSR. Mimi?
Yes, ma'am.
All of the three talk about CSR. So I really suggest you, it is strongly suggested that you need to find one about whisperers.
What, ma'am?
Whisperers.
Oh, Whisperers is a new platform, ma'am. So there is no research that related to Whisperers.
Okay, deal. So if you don't want to put any Whisperers in your previous study and you don't want to talk about it because you don't have any, what is that, any landasan or any fundamental theories for that. So I really suggest you to delete Whisperers in your title.
I delete, but I can use it as the...
Yes, you still can use it as the media. Just talk, just say in your proposal that the media you will use is Whisperers. Yeah, but you do not test Whisperers. You do not test, I mean like test, experiment that Whisperers.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. That's only the suggestion, yeah. That's only suggestion. You just think about it and discuss it later. Now, my question is, it's related to your background. I think it's very important also for the audience here just to differentiate about the background between quantitative, experimental, and also the qualitative. So if you want to do quantitative research, Mimi, what is your basic?
Data.
Alasannya. Di background, your background. Talk about your background. I want to investigate the significant effect of CSR because what is your reason?
Why, ma'am?
What is your reason?
The reasons
for the experimental.
I choose experimental.
Yeah. The reason, no. The reason, your background of the study. Alasannya apa? Background-nya apa? Sehingga jadinya effect gitu loh, sehingga kuantitatif.
Because I want to prove that CSR and Whisperers can affect the students' reading comprehensions of narrative.
Why? You want to prove? Yes. Kenapa dengan CSR-nya? Ada apa sih dengan CSR-nya? What is its strengths, for example, or weaknesses, or
The strengths for CSR that students can work cooperatively with their friends. You know, when the students is kinda antisocial for their friends.
Siapa yang bilang antisocial?
Because my experience when I do the teaching practice.
Okay, go on.
And then that's CSR with they can work with their friends that have more knowledge, so they can share with their friends.
Okay, I get your point. The purpose of collaborative learning is to make the students familiar with their environments and friends, right?
Yes.
But don't say any antisocial because we don't have any data.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, just say that in your proposal like this. Because CSR can improve students' social or what is that? Yeah, students' sense of being social and blah 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 to work together, blah 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 to appreciate others, blah blah blah. Not antisocial.
Oh yes, ma'am. Sorry,
yeah, I don't agree with that.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Although in fact, some of the students, or most of the students now are antisocial because they are really into in their gadget. But for me, saying someone antisocial need more further research.
Yes, ma'am. Sorry, ma'am.
Okay. Now, Miming, if you say that your basic is to prove the strategy to be effective.
Yes,
ma'am. In your samples or population, I suggest you to delete your problems. You said that based on my PPL, I don't remember. Based on your teaching practice experience, if I'm not mistaken, in your background,
yes.
You said that the student have problem, blah 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 blah.
Mm-hmm.
So we are not talking about the problems when you want to test the strategy. We mostly talk about the strategy itself.
Yes.
Jadi kita bicara strateginya, bukan problemnya. Apapun problemnya, itu akan diselesaikan later on. Because you have the strategy, you have the strength, and you believe that the strength can overcome the problems. But don't talk about the problems.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. That's all for background. Now let's go to pre-experimental. I just want to test you now. Do you know about pre-experimental research? Do you know how it works? What is pre-experimental?
Pre-experimental is that consists of one class to be the sample, ma'am.
One class, and then
before the treatment, I will give the free test, and then I will give the treatment, and I will give the post test after the treatment.
So what are to be compared?
The students' score, ma'am.
Okay, student score before and after.
Yes.
Right? Now, do you know that pre-experimental is the weakest experiment among all? The weakest, paling lemah.
Yes.
Do you know why?
No, but I know it's the weakest.
Okay, because the data is compared to themselves, the students and themselves, not other students. So why don't you choose quasi? Yeah. Why? Why? I just want to know your reason.
Because on that time when I do the teaching practice, I asked the teacher if I can do the research on the student's class, but the teacher suggests to be one classmate. But if need change it, I can talk with the teacher later.
It's quite acceptable, Miming. It's okay for me. If it is possible, you can do quasi. Although I know using quasi means you will work more.
Yes.
Yeah, but it's up to you. Quasi is better, but if you want to use for experimental, it is acceptable for me. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Yeah, just think about it. Think about the time to do the research, mm-hmm. about your due date on the graduation and something like that. Think about it.
Yes.
Yeah, ma'am. I just want to make it easier for you.
Because on that day, the teacher suggests me to research the one class because her reasons because of the social the distancing, ma'am.
So, but you can talk again.
Yes.
To her. Yeah.
Later I will talk to her.
But later it's up to you, okay? Yes. Just talk to her, but the decision is on your hand. And your advisor.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. That's all for pre-experimental. It seems that you understand how it works. Did you put any clue cards, cue cards in your proposal?
Cue
cards. CUE. I just find the learning book. What page?
Yes, ma'am. I put the leader's cue card.
Oh, that's only for the leader. That's yes. The leader's cue card. Oh, not for all the members of the group.
No.
Okay. Get your point. Thank you. So, in whispering, as the media, you said that it is kind of animated narratives. Animated. So yeah. It has or they have pictures.
Can I show you, ma'am?
No, that's okay. That's okay. I can find it myself.
Yeah.
And I know it has pictures, right?
Yes.
But in your proposal, you just narrate the whispering in one paragraph. in bab 2.
Yes.
You just say the blah 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 without any picture.
Yes.
Put the pictures.
Oh, okay.
So maybe the readers can know, oh, this is the whispering. So the home screen and then the narratives from the application.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Yeah. The real or the authentic, the authentic pictures of the application. Get the point?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now let's go to Miming. When you want to assess or evaluate your students' reading comprehension using tests, for example, do you think you need a rubric?
Yes.
Why don't you put any rubric?
I put it, ma'am, on the last.
Which one? Halaman, page? 93.
The paper is not changed.
93 or 92. It's in 92. Which one? Scoring the test item. This N per 25 dikali 100, is it?
Yes.
Ah, that's not the scoring rubric. That's the scoring system. Rubric means, for example, you combine two kinds of evaluation or test item in your RPP, short answer and multiple choice. Why don't you choose one of them?
I choose the multiple choice, man.
I read you have the short answer. For example, what is the main ideas of the story?
It's all about the multiple choice, ma'am.
Oh, it's multiple choice. Wait a minute.
Yes.
So the structure of the paper seems different. Oh, multiple choice.
Yes. Can I chance? I need chance?
It's better for you to have short answer because the purpose of CSR is to help the student find the gist. For example, yeah, misalnya the place, the time. So do not what class? SMA, right?
SMA.
Do not any multiple choice. Short answers better.
Yeah.
Okay. You can still use this kind of item, but not in multiple choice form.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, SMA. If it is SMP, okay, nggak apa-apa. Go ahead. But this is SMA.
Yes.
Yeah. Just to make sure that CSR works here.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. Rubric. For the rubric, if it is short answer, you can use any rubric that you think appropriate. For example, short answer, they have, for example, what is the moral value of this story? For example, do not be greedy. For example, yeah, do not be greedy. For example, you give 2 for the score. And then if the student write like this, do not be greedy, misalnya, greedy is not good. For example, yeah, it's not really similar to the first yang kamu minta tadi yang do not be greedy. Nah, what score you want to give to the students? For example, 1 because the structure is not correct or the idea is not complete. Do you get the point, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
If it is multiple choice, berarti kan 1-0,
mm-hmm.
Ya kan? Correct 1, wrong 0. Nah, for the short answers, you can use 2-1, 5-2, or whatever you want.
Yes, ma'am.
2-1-0. 0 if it is not connected at all. 1 is not complete. 2 is fully complete.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah? Get my point, yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
My suggestion. Write them all in your RPP.
Yes.
Quite a lot, see, but you can do it. I believe it. Okay. RPP. In your RPP, this is the last confirmation from you. Please tell me about CSR in your RPP, because in CSR, after you assign the students, for example, one group consists of 4 students, right?
Yes.
Leader, and then the announcer as the last Q experts. Expert is it? What is that? Expert. Klang or click expert?
Click and klang expert, man.
Click and klang expert, and then satunya lagi.
Get lupa. Click. Expert.
GIS expert.
Yes.
Nah, you do not put any step in assigning the students in your RPP. Gimana taunya? In your RPP, you just said that the group of the student 4, the group consists of 4.
Yes.
And then langsung aja tuh ngerjain, nggak ada assigning-nya. Nanti assigning-nya maksudnya setelah mereka dalam satu tim, how they can divide the roles.
Oh yes, ma'am.
Ya, itu ditulis.
Yes.
Jadi siapa misalnya student 1 leader, student 4 announcer. And then you need to describe the roles in your RPP. Apa yang harus dilakukan nanti? Kan itu nggak ada langsung jawab-jawab yes, aja.
Yeah.
Ya kan?
Ya yeah, nggak ada.
Ya, yeah. You need to recreate your RPP. Meaning this is one of the most important point. Ya. Yeah.
Yes,
karena ma'am. Your RPP will be the what is that? Will be the key.
The
The guide and the key for this research. Okay.
Yes,
make sure that you focus on fixing this kind of RPP.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah?
Yes,
okay. Ibu Yuli, thank you very much. I think it's all.
Okay, thank you, Ibu Maida. Okay, meaning, is it clear for you what Ibu Maida has already asked you related to your proposal?
If I confuse, can I ask for Maida?
Sure.
Yeah, that's the purpose. Yeah, I ask you. Oh, masih ada yang bingung.
Yes, clear, ma'am.
Oh, jelas ya. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Well, actually, this is related to the title, yeah, Ibu Maida, yeah. In the beginning, meaning just write CSR, CSR, mm-hmm. yeah. But then, because I also have another, what is it? Anak bimbingan with the other lecturer, yeah, who combined these two things, just like the strategy and then the media, because according to the advisor, it is impossible just to use a strategy without the support of any good media. But actually, at the time, I consider it's good, yeah. But regarding the research, nah ini masalah researchnya nih lagi nih.
Yeah.
Saya yang mungkin tidak terlalu paham tentang itu ya. Saya terus terang saja ya. Nah jadi kalau secara logika, I think it's quite makes sense. I mean, if you have a good strategy but without the support of good media, sometimes it doesn't work very well. But if we put it in the title like this, it is really problematic, ya Ibu Maida. Ya.
Yeah,
bisa, ya.
Just to make it easier, because two variables like this should be in doctorate, because you
oh, yeah, have yeah.
more participants or more samples.
Oh,
and
yeah.
long time. And not yeah. pre-experimental for me, ya. Yeah.
Okay, ya yeah, benar. Antara pre-eksperimental itu benar, seharusnya ini paling enggak ya itu tadi kuasai, paling enggak ini ya.
Ya, paling enggak kuasai.
Ini memang, ya oke lah Miming, jadi bebannya terlalu berat.
Kasihan saya pas baca. Whispering. Maksud saya kalau ini, tadi kan saya sempat nanya Bu yang previous tadi, terus dia bilang tidak ada teori.
Iya, karena itu baru memang.
Iya. Jadi kalau
memang tujuannya mencari yang baru gitu.
Nah,
karena
kalau
kan
mau
banyak
yang baru, mending whispering aja satu gitulah biar jadi basic.
Oh.
Karena tuh orang yang mencoba aplikasi aja kan whisperingnya gitu. Jadi strateginya konvensional gitu. Sayangnya nggak ada bilang.
Iya. Jadi mungkin kalau buat dia ini lebih baik memang itu saja, apa CSR saja, tapi tidak usah media itu di situ ya.
Ya title aja Bu, kalau mau dimasukin nggak apa-apa.
Oh iya ya, untuk title-nya aja ya, tetap nanti dalam pengembangannya ya itu bisa seperti itu. Ini karena memang kalau kita mengajar pun, biarpun strategi kita ini, tapi media tidak mendukung, itu problematik juga kan, seringkali kan. Jadi itu bisa sebagai nilai tambah, tapi untuk title-nya, mengamankannya, itu tetap CSR, tapi whispers itu tetap dimasukkan gitu, mimik di dalam media. Dan memang itu di RPP tadi memang belum terlalu kelihatan juga, ya memang itu tujuannya dia seminar, supaya ada yang review bagian-bagian mana yang kurang begitu, karena memang di langkah-langkahnya itu kemarin, ya oke lah, daripada dia kelamaan, kan langsung di situ aja.
Iya, Bu.
Iya, dan ini saya sebenarnya ada bingung miming. Oke, sebentar, kalau di title itu thesis proposal atau proposal aja sih sebenarnya?
Thesis proposal kan?
Iya, seharusnya thesis proposal ya. Tidak proposal aja ya. Saya tuh baru lihat.
Yes, ma'am.
Thesis ya, seharusnya ya, Ming ya.
Saya tulis kemarin thesis proposal, kayaknya ini, ma'am, kekesep.
Oh, pantas. Saya juga mau nanya.
Oh, iya.
Cuma itu saya
takutnya apa saya ya?
Maaf, ma'am, sorry.
It's okay ya, just to make sure apakah memang di panduan juga begitu.
Karena terus di panduan itu, Bu, bahasa Indonesia kan proposal skripsi.
Iya.
Berarti kan terjemahan, kalau menurut saya ya, diterjemahkan thesis proposal, cuman nggak tahu kenapa.
Iya, ya nggak apa-apa, perasaan saya juga thesis proposal gitu, cuman dia ini kok proposal aja gitu ya, apa yang di ininya. Nah, ini terus ini juga miming di bagian ini. Saya tuh melihat di bagian, kalau yang introduction tadi kan sudah dibantu banyak ya oleh Ibu Maida, ya benar dia ini. Itu masukan yang sangat berharga, Ibu Maida ya. In a way that, I don't know with the other students here. Sometimes they don't even put it in quotes. They just copy that and paste. Yeah. kalau miming ini kan dia masih put in quote, jadi kelihatan bisa diarahkan. Kalau yang lain itu, sudah jelas-jelas kayaknya nggak mungkin dia yang nulis, tapi dia tidak put in quote. Nah, nggak tahu nih yang hadir di sini nih apa. Nah, itu yang seringkali buat kita juga pusing. Jadi memang sih idealnya miming ya bisa diparaphrase. Ada beberapa begitu bisa diparaphrase. Jadi pusing bolehnya apa. Tapi saya tuh kadang mikir mahasiswa nih sanggup kah enggak gitu nih. Tapi kalau dia nih kayaknya sanggup ya.
Sanggup aja, Bu. Bisa aja.
Sanggup ya, Ming. Ya, masa kamu anak
ya, Ming.
Bisa.
Biar bisa.
Sudah ada Bu Moida. Kalau yang lain itu terus terang saya memang agak sakit kepala. Dia nih tekun gitu, Mai, sanggup dia. Yeah. Makanya saya juga okay lah, dicobalah sama miring mungkin dia ini. Nah, untunglah dapat Bu Maida juga yang bisa mengarahkan dengan sangat baik. Yeah.
Overall bagus kok, Bu. Overall tuh
struktur.
Cuman ya itu karena saya berpikir terlalu berat. Berat itu maksud saya tidak meremehkan miming ya, Ming ya. Yeah. Cuman kalau kita bicara due date-nya graduation, terus lagi
S2 ya paling enggak ya.
Habis itu di sekolah kan tidak seperti yang kita harapkan. Kadang-kadang, Bu, tiba-tiba siswanya nggak ada yang masuk lah, tiba-tiba kelasnya bukan kelas yang bagus lah. Kan banyak hal yang harus gitu pre-eksperimental lagi.
Benar. Ini nanti udah tatap muka ya, Ming, ya? Semuanya ya?
Masih hybrid, Mem.
Oh, masih ya?
Iya, setengah populasinya di rumah, setengah di ruangan.
Jadi nanti, jangan-jangan mereka yang full ini cuma karena mau ulangan kali ya?
Iya.
Saya dengar ada yang mau, oleh anak saya udah full semua, Mai.
Iya, atau kalau boleh minta tolong aja kamu yang face to face.
Iya, bisa, Mem.
Minta tolong. Minta yang itu jadwal face to face aja ya, Bu, ya. Kalau hybrid nanti susah, bingung anunya. Takutnya nanti keliru hasilnya tuh.
Iya, benar, Mem. Benar juga. Karena eksperimen ini susah sih kalau hybrid. Gimana ngamatinnya?
Susah, benar. Karena waktu juga dipertimbangkan, terus masalahnya kan kita kan mau mengukur si SR-nya apakah worth atau tidak. Nanti kalau dibantu di online dictionary segala macam, jadi kan terpengaruh hasilnya kan kalau di rumah mereka buka.
Iya.
Soalnya mereka lagi ulangan ini juga, Mem.
Oh iya, bukannya sekarang maksudnya nanti itu.
Oh iya.
Kalau ada itu kan cari yang tatap muka misalnya ada pembagian.
Iya.
Atau minta lah, Bu, lah kalau misalnya tolong aja 2 atau 3 minggu gitu yang ini.
Iya. Mungkin nanti akan full kayaknya. Kalau kata guru, maunya guru.
Saya kan, juga karena yakinnya full nih. Mulai habis ulangan ini, kan Mimi ngambil datanya kan Juli, paling enggak ya.
Ya, Mem.
Kemungkinan itu sudah full kok. Jadi, mungkin lah, Bu, lah mungkin.
Dan kalau Miming awal-awal itu lebih membantu, Ming. Mereka tidak terlalu chaos, sibuk ya. Malah mungkin masih bisa diatur gitu ya, Maya. Kalau dia mau yang mana gitu. Tapi kalau sudah masuk tengah dan akhir, itu guru juga udah stres.
Ya,
guru dia sudah stres gitu.
Manfaatkan momen lah ya untuk ini.
Ya, jadi dia nih pas nih waktu mereka ini dia seminar, setelah itu kan dia agak leluasa berkomunikasi dengan sekolah juga kan.
Iya,
Untuk
benar-benar.
mencari waktu yang terbaik untuk ini. Nah, yang saya tanyakan itu Ming, saya tuh baru ngeliat tadi ya Ming, sorry Ming. Ibu tidak menanyakan, ibu cuma sekedar ini aja yang research delimitation Ming. Research delimitation page berapa itu ya? Page 7 ya Ming ya?
Ya, Mem.
Nah, di situ Ming menulis the focus of reading material in this research in narratives and theories about reading comprehension level. Maksudmu apa yang theories about reading comprehension level ini?
Teori yang related sama permasalahan siswa yang ada di background-nya, Mem.
Berarti levelnya nggak perlu, maksudnya. Oh. Karena bicara level reading tuh lain lagi.
Iya. Kenapa kamu nggak langsung sebutkan aja apa gitu, Mim? Kalau gini kan kita nggak tahu siapa yang mana yang kamu acu dari sekian banyak teorimu itu.
Iya.
Ya, Bu Maida ya?
Iya, Bu.
Tandanya dia mau pilih level. Oh, kemarin saya ingat level itu kan dia tuh ada membuat level-level reading comprehension, Ibu Maida.
Ada di reading up, ada di chapter 2.
Ah, di chapter 2.
Saya lebih suka itu dihapus, Bu.
Dihapus aja kah?
Keduanya. Karena kalau itu kan dia nggak mengelompokkan nanti. Kan Mimi nggak ada mengelompokin kah nanti hasilnya, misalnya ini levelnya apa gitu. Adakah?
Enggak, Mem.
Enggak sih, cuman oleh dia kemarin itu di teorinya itu ada memang itu.
Iya, ada
sih. Makanya saya tanya, kenapa nggak kamu sesuaikan dengan teorinya? Rasanya seperti itu ya, Ming, ya?
Iya, Mem.
Kenapa nggak disesuaikan? Karena dia itu memang ada yang literal comprehension, ada interpretive, ada critical.
Ya.
Nah, apakah dia ini misalnya ya, dia berfokus kepada critical aja, jadi nanti memang otomatis soal-soalnya itu diarahkan ke yang critical ya. Comprehension. Apakah
saya lebih fokus ke itu, Mem, yang kedua.
Apa itu? Interpretive.
Iya, interpretive.
Interpretive.
Ya udah berarti itu nanti ditekankan aja nggak apa-apa
ya deh. Jadi nanti kalau kamu ada soal yang di pretest post test kan diarahkan ke situ kan, jadi ini lebih ke yang reading comprehension yang interpretif gitu.
Saya baru ingat Bu, ada hubungannya sama yang soal yang Ibu bilang diarahkan ke interpretif itu. Saya juga bertanya, yakin kan bahwa semua soal itu memang dilatih melalui CSR?
Iya.
Misalnya clicks itu kan words, misalnya mengenali kata huruf. Apakah ada nanti di soal? Saya lihat ada sih. Misalnya, terus lagi yang gis. Gis itu kan tempat, waktu, apa tadi segala macam ya. Pastikan juga ada di ininya.
Jadi saya ada buat comprehension, 4 comprehension itu Mem di soalnya. Ada word comprehension, sentence comprehension, paragraph comprehension, dengan text comprehension.
Tapi itu sesuai nggak sama CSR dan interpretative? Sesuai nggak? Baca dulu lagi ya.
Iya, Mem.
Harus ada yang CSR ada, interpretatifnya ada.
Pastikan nyambung juga dari CSR itu sih sebenarnya ininya. Ya, itu aja sih, Ming. Karena saya tuh kayak ngambang-ngambang kalimat yang di situ itu.
Iya, Mem.
Dan itu kelewat ya. Sudah, oke lah. Pokoknya dia mungkin nanti kan pasti ada bantuan dari Ibu Susan dengan Ibu Maida gitu. Oke. Ya, oke. No more question from Miming ya, Ibu Maida.
It's okay, Ibu. It's quite a lot. So you just keep spirit for that. Quite a lot, beneran. Quite a lot.
Ya, dan untung dia juga, dia paham yang dia tulis, makanya.
Paham, but quite a lot. Saya bilang kan, paham quite a lot, tapi pasti bisa. Kalau paham. Kalau nggak paham, walau sedikit, pasti nggak bisa.
Ya, oke.
Ya, Mem. Emang problem saya tuh emang di quotation, Mem. Lihat dulu.
Belajar
dari dulu.
Pelajari lagi.
Ya nggak apa-apa. Saya masih menghargai dia tidak kopas. Karena yang lain itu kopas, Mai. Jadi kalau sudah ditanya itu langsung hilang mereka.
Ya, Bu, masalahnya itu dia itu kan ada sudah berusaha untuk mengcopy yang benar. Tapi cara penulisannya yang salah. Coba
ya, benar, benar, benar. Ya. Ya, makanya dia di seminar supaya dia bisa ini menulis yang benarnya. Jadi biar ini lebih bagus ini ya maksudnya.
Iya benar. Saya hargai juga dia maksudnya benar mengambil. Ya. Tapi itu di quote semua terus dia nggak tahu cara menulisnya yang benar tuh gimana kan ada strukturnya misalnya nih. Ada yang stated misalnya itu ini stated ya dipetikin sama dia kan nggak boleh. Nah itu maksud saya.
Ya, oke. Okay. Itu di mata kuliah scientific writing ya, Mia?
Sudah saya tulis ya.
Oh, di... sudah diambil Bu Maria juga. Sudah. Bu Maria, Bu Maida. Ya,
saya tulis, baca lagi buku scientific writing-nya.
Iya, ya, benar-benar. Oke. Okay. Ya, thank you very much Ibu Maida for the very valuable review ya for Mining's thesis proposal. And meaning you should revise yeah based on the question and the feedback from Ibu Maida, and the time is usually 2 weeks. The maximum is 2 weeks, ya yeah, Ming. Biasanya waktu revisinya itu 2 weeks. And then after you finish, you can go to Ibu Maida first to ask for her what is it consideration whether it is already appropriate according to what she asks you this afternoon, ya? Yeah?
Yes.
Jadi waktunya 2 minggu ya, hitung aja ini sudah tanggal berapa, ini tanggal 6 ya, berarti maksimal tanggal 27 paling lambat. Tapi but I think before that you should consult first ya, jangan tunggu pas 2 minggunya baru datang, saya kira ya. Ya, yeah. Is it okay Bu Maida? Kalau dia sebelum 2 minggu itu dia ada konsultasi dulu sebelum ini.
It's okay Ibu, but next week or this week I will
next week
be a little Ibu bit slow responded ya.
Yeah, not available sama kayak saya juga karena ada tugas di luar gitu. Kalau saya memang ada keperluan saya pribadi ya untuk
saya juga ada tugas obat. Kebetulan harus belajar juga di UMM sebentar jadi.
Iya benar, itu juga tugas berat ya.
Iya.
Ya oke. Okay. Nah, jadi Mimi 1 minggu kamu kerjakan itu revisinya, setelah itu silahkan konsultasikan ke Bu Maida kalau ada yang mungkin kamu tidak paham ya bagian ininya ya. Oke, ini yang ada ini tidak perlu di screenshot kah anak-anak ini? Kamu sudah screenshot kah?
Ada recording, bisa aja nanti kan di capture.
Oh iya, ada recording. Mereka tidak pernah on kamera ya dari tadi ya?
Takut mungkin.
Takut ya. Oleh rasanya ada kata-kata on kamera apa di catatannya Pak Wahyu. Oh, ini sudah ada Adelia ini. Adelia sama Liska. Ya, oke. Okay. Kenapa takut ya jadi on kamera? Enggak juga. Oke. Okay. So, I think that's all for this morning. Yeah, thank you very much. The result, yeah, meaning ya, yeah, the score for you will be known after you give the revisions, yeah. After you get the score from Ibu Maida, Ibu Susan, and I, yeah. Later, yeah, after your 2 weeks revisions, yeah. Okay. Question meaning? Maybe that I forget. Ada yang saya lupa mungkin nggak?
Nggak ada, ma'am.
Nggak ada, yeah. If you don't have any questions, I think this is the end of the seminar this morning. Thank you very much again, Ibu Maida, and then meaning. Yeah,
ma'am.
And all the students. Huh? Kenapa lagi nih?
Ya, terima kasih memang sebenarnya.
Oh, saya kira kamu mau bertanya. Sorry. Yeah. So, thank you very much again and good morning for everybody. See you again next time. Yeah, we live together. Yeah, thank you. Ma'am. Makasih ya Bu Maida.
Sama Bu Yuli.
Terima kasih, ma'am. Ma'am Maida, ma'am Yuli. Mohon bantuannya, ma'am.
Oke, okay, kita lihat sama-sama ya. Thank you. Good morning.
Ya. Yeah.